More excitement as the finals come in for the women's floor. And for me, sounded almost a sense of sadness that this is the last event for the artistic, because it's been a heck of a ride. We've had such wonderful competition and such great champions.
It's been amazing. I always think about gymnastics having so many different competitions, the teams, the all-around, then each of the event finals. It goes so fast. These athletes have worked so long for this two and a half week period. Put it all on the line, and this is a tremendous lineup on the floor exercise tonight. We've got the past world champion from 2011, from 2010, past Olympic champions, 2008 and 2004.
That's probably the most surprising thing about it, that the two Romanians, Pernot and Esbasa, Olympic champions, both of them, 04 and 08, and still here, and world champions in there. So we have two competitors from the Russian Federation, two from the USA, two from Romania. The interlopers, if you like, are from Australia and Italy, but Lauren Mitchell, a former world champion, Vanessa Ferrari from Italy, a former world all-around champion. So everybody brings serious credibility to this final, Shannon. What's your gut feeling about how it might go?
I'm afraid to guess anymore.
I shouldn't put you on the spot, should I? I haven't done that before, and I shouldn't do it with the last one. But we just sit back and enjoy. That's what we should do, because we've been surprised every time by the quality of performances. Sometimes the favourites have come through and sometimes not, but we've always been given a treat. And it starts right now with Ksenia Afanaseva.
And what we hope for is a clean competition where everyone hits, and then we see how they stack up. World champion 2011 on this event, opening up huge double layout, fighting to stay in bounds. Flag goes up. Whip, whip to triple fold. Beautiful. Beautiful gymnast to watch. Combining the artistry along with powerful tumbling. One and a half and out of bounds again. Difficult to tell if she went out with only 1 foot or two. 1 foot is 1/10, 2 feet is 3/10 of a deduction. Finishing up her Olympics. A couple of big deductions there with the steps out of bounds.
And I think that explains that sort of neutral expression as she leaves the floor. It wasn't quite what she wanted for Afanasieva, who qualified fourth best with 14.833. But it was touch and go the first out of bounds.
And she really looked like she was going to hold on to it. Sign of, just with that right little toe.
That's all it takes.
And this one way out, almost landing out of bounds, very close.
Well, as we've remarked throughout the floor competition, men and women, it's a springy one. And at times even slippery.
That's what the athletes have been telling us. It's kind of hard throughout, but springy on the diagonal where you tumble. And that can throw you way out of bounds.
Well, respectable, but not likely to be medal winning. 15.566. Let's see how it holds up. You just don't know. Jordan Weber.
Jordan Weber, all-around world champion from 2011. She has become a crowd favorite. Nearly missed an opportunity for the all-around competition. Opens with a huge pass, double twisting, double back. A little bounce on that landing, but she managed to stay in bounds. Gonna have to triple, and she's out as well. Jordan has worked so hard, spent such a great deal of time on flexibility, her dance over the years. Really trying to match how well she does in the power area with the tumbling. Performance, but again, just those landings, seeing out of bounds, and just a couple little steps here and there.
And the field for the women's floor have really had to wait quite a while since this finals session began to have the chance to perform.
And that's right, what they do is they'll warm up in the back off of the podium while the men are competing on their events. And right here you can see, trying to hold on to that landing. Right here, she'll go one and a half right through to a triple full, and that leap just put her out. She got a little bit more horizontal movement backwards than she wanted to go a little bit more vertical. You see these athletes doing lots of jumps out of their tumbling passes. It helps with that landing. You no longer can do the lunge out, you have to stick the landing or do a jump out.
So waiting for Weber's score, 14.566 for Afanasieva. Weber, second competitor, and fellow American Ali Raisman is next. She's encouraging her while she waits for her own score, Weber.
Weber was 14.666 during the qualification round.
Hold up doesn't seem to be with those two judges. They're looking around as though they finished whatever they need to do. Never easy for the next competitor.
Here's another look at the first tumbling pass. Two twists, two flips before she hits the ground. So much power goes into that move. You can see the spring and the give in the floor during that slow motion replay.
And 14-5, the score is in for Jordan Weber. So he slides in behind Afanaseva. So I don't think we've seen the winning performance yet. And the number one qualifier for the floor final with a 15-3-2-5.
She has a huge opening tumbling pass. Such a strong, steady competitor. One and a half twist. Punch, double Arabian, punch layout, and nails it. Comes back, pike to double Arabian, another clean landing. Gold in the team, bronze in the beam. Final triple twist. She's got one pass left.
Crowd loved it with good reason. That is a performance to beat in the floor final. Ali Raisman.
And her enormous 6.5 star value tops the field. Add on top of that, clean execution, perfect landings.
Hard to think of a mistake in there. It was very clean and very impressive.
If there was one, I didn't really see it. You know, minor little things if we're going to get picky, but the landings were very clean. And Marta Caroli, the U.S. program coordinator, has said, you know, it's just proof that hard work pays off because Ali is the most hardworking, dedicated athlete throughout the year. That's high praise.
And they say the harder you work, the luckier you get. But no luck really in this. This is a performance that deserves a high mark. It'll get one.
Not touted as the one coming in, and she could be the U.S. athlete that walks away with three medals from these games.
Must be 15-something.
She was 15-3-2-5 in the qualification.
15-6 here. And she's over a full mark higher than Afanaseva and Weber.
And dare I say, I think that's the highest score that we've seen in women's floor exercise.
Right.
Not just today, overall.
That's an amazing contribution to make to the sport, and perhaps a gold medal one for Raisman. We've got five to come.
And this woman here, Olympic champion on this event in 2004. Gorgeous opening double layout. back whip whip to a pike full in, right to a back pike. Honor is so calm and collected through competition. She actually had her hand slip during this pass. The triple full during qualification maintained her composure and made it into the final round. Oh, another great landing.
Well, she gives the judges fever with this performance. It's unbelievable. If she can keep it going to the end, it might put some pressure on Raisman.
Pike to finish.
But that's her best.
That was a terrific performance.
And yet again, in a final, we're seeing athletes step up and deliver better than their qualifying score. Raisman 15-6. I don't know if anyone can get near it, but Pono is certainly trying.
This is going to be tight. I mean, this was a terrific performance from Catalina Ponor, but no one else in the field has the difficulty value of Raisman. But these landings were spot on. And it's just tremendous to see Catalina out there competing at this high of level, still vying for Olympic medals 8 years after she did so in 2004. .14.6 during the qualification round, where she had a slight mistake.
She turned 25 later this month, maybe. We expect this to be her last Olympics. And a 15-2 for Ponor. It's a great score, much better than qualifying, but she can't get near Raisman and into second place.
And we hear boos from the audience, but 6.2 in difficulty value compared to a 6.5 for Ali Raisman. So it was a great score. That was Ponor's highest score, beautiful routine, and should keep her in silver.
Lauren Mitchell, a former world champion on floor from 2010, came into the Olympics slightly injured with an abdominal strain, but she's had a few days extra to get that right. Let's see what she can do here.
And Lauren dealing with not only the abdominal strain, which affects everything that you do, but the tear in her shoulder as well has caused her to lose a little bit of strength. Whip to double Arabian. Beautiful opening pass. Coming back, pike full in. A little bit low on that jump out. Very minor deduction.
Oh, another great performance. We're seeing a few. Lauren Mitchell seeking to become the first Australian to get a medal in an apparatus final. But the competition's so hot, Shannon. I don't know if she can do it.
It is so tough, and Lauren is accustomed to making history, becoming Australia's first female gymnast to win a world championship. Is in final in this event. Huge opening pass, whip directly to a double Arabian. Nice dad leap at the end.
She comes from Perth in Western Australia. And there's a great gymnastics program there under the Western Australian Institute of Sport. She's really had a couple of years troubled by injury. So to make a final here, it's been great performance from her.
Came in with a 14.833 during the qualification round. Put her in the fifth position coming into this competition.
Haven't heard definitively if this is the end of her gymnastics career. It might be, though. And we'll see if it's one to remember alongside a medal. Get past Athens Saver, she needs a high 14. Sorry, Shannon.
That's right. And she could place in the high 14s, 15.833, and she has equaled that again tonight.
14.833 for Mitchell into third position ahead of Athens Saver and Weber. But three very good performances to come from Ferrari, Mustafina, and Izbasa. Italy, Russia, and Romania still to come.
Vanessa, the 2006 World All-Around Champion. And she's coming into tonight's final on floor exercise in third position. Opening up, huge double-double. Known for her exciting choice of attire as well as her power. Start value coming in with a 6.2 in difficulty value. And a great finish.
Well, Vanessa Ferrari's already made history for Italian gymnastics when, as a 15-year-old, she won that world all-around title. I wonder if she can do something again that'll have the Italian media going crazy for her, as they've done in the past.
When you think of gymnastics being the young woman's sport, and yet we're seeing a lot of these two-time Olympians, two, three, even four-time world champion, at least competitors in the world championships. So, you know, it seems like there's a little bit more longevity in the sport these days. This was a great routine. You know, just a couple little minor mistakes on landings, a little bit in the leap area. But again, she has a pretty good start value with 6.2. She's hovering typically around a 14.9, 14.866 here at the games.
14.833 is the mark Lauren Mitchell holds in third position at the moment. So Ferrari can certainly get near that. See them puffing away, you realize how hard they're working for that 90 seconds, Shannon.
It really is incredible. I mean, there's so much tumbling that you have to pack in to that 90 seconds. You really don't have that much time to breathe.
The judge is making us sweat this one out for on Ferrari's behalf.
Have another look at her performance. Or not. And the crowd is getting a little antsy.
What a serious hand injury in 2005. With four screws placed in the hand. And surgery. But that's the kind of stories not uncommon at all. And Ferrari moves into third place with a 14-9. So there will be no historic medal for Lauren Mitchell, but maybe for Ferrari. Still two performances to come, though. One of them from Alia Mustafina, who has already won gold on uneven bars. Third in the all-around, second in the team. So she's got the full set, gold, silver, and bronze.
Huge opening, Arabian tuck double. Perfectly vertical. Two and a half punch full, and she has been such a joy to watch. Certainly not expected to take the gold on any of the bars, and came through exactly the right time. Mentioned her injury, major ACL tear just 18 months ago. And it's so important when you think about floor exercise and the pounding that your knees take. Finishes up triple full. And that was a terrific performance, yeah. A couple little errors here and there. I saw a little bit of a step on some of the landings and knee bend on that triple twist. So those execution deductions are going to add up.
I just think the performance from Raisman is almost intimidating with a 15-6. Not that Pono was intimidated. She came out with a 15-2 and the crowd thought it should have been more. But for the rest of the field, something in the mid-15s feels like it's unachievable.
It really is incredible to watch, and it kind of makes it a race for silver, although Sandra Zbasha, who is the last competitor, could get there with a perfect routine. And in this from Mustafina, terrific opening tumbling pass. Again, you see just a little bit of a flicker in the knees on some of these tumbling runs. Comes in with a 15.9 in difficulty value from the qualification round.
So the first barrier to get past is 14.9. That is Ferrari in the bronze medal position. Ponor on 15.2. Raisman 15.6.
I think with this routine, slipping into that bronze medal position would certainly not be unheard of. She consistently places mid to high 14s.
As each gymnast competes and completes, they know their competition is over. Mustafina 14.9 also, but gets it on execution ahead of Ferrari. Wow. Yet again, the tiebreak rules are applied to the scores, and Ferrari looking disconsolate. Could all be academic if this buser comes up and gets into the medals as well. Ponor still sitting in second because she lost out on the tiebreak when it was applied in the beam.
That's right, that's right. So Ali Raisman, Catalina Ponor, good for medals. Just a matter of what color. And Sandra Izbasha taking the gold on vault in huge upset. Really performing terrifically.
Last routine, Artistic Gymnastics 2012.
Sandra Izbasha is the reigning Olympic champion on this event. Gorgeous opening pass. And she is so clean on these landings. Watching the drop of that heel, make sure those turns are completed 360 degrees. Issue there on the last tumbling pass, and it was such a gorgeous routine.
What a shame for Sandra Izbasha, but that is a really significant deduction.
Oh, we talk about the timing on those bounding moves. Ali Raisman knows she has the gold.
Oh, that's just such a tough break for Izbasha. The last couple of seconds of her routine was going so well, she could have medaled.
Absolutely. Up until that fall, certainly she would have had one of the medals. Otherwise, terrific performance. That's her piked full in. Perfect landing.
We should get a look in slow-mo at what went wrong, Shannon, and if you can spot it for us. That's where the difficulty was.
Well, and those bounding passes are very difficult because you have to have the timing just right. And here is where she went wrong. And just what we call kind of double bounce is what we call it in this sport. And just did not get the right punch for that second move.
So disappointment ultimately for Izbasha, but joy for Ali Raisman, Catalina Ponor. Malia Mustafina, they look like your gold, silver, and bronze medalists. USA, Romania, and Russia. Mustafina has had the kind of Olympics that perhaps Komova was hoping for and expecting, and many of us were. It's Mustafina who has stood up, performed, and collected. And it should be bronze for her.
Another look at Izbasha, not going home empty-handed. She has a gold on vault. Unfortunately, floor was not working for her tonight.
And a 13.333 for Izbasha. She was heavily penalized for what happened at the end of her routine there. And she's resigned to that. And perhaps, too, we've seen a great gymnast exiting the scene, maybe not. Young enough to keep going, but Raisman, what a performance she gave us on floor. 15-6, absolutely stellar. Ponor with a 15-2. And Mustafina, 14-9 for the bronze medal. But Raisman, one of the truly great performances on floor. seen anywhere, anytime.
And she has been so steady, so consistent, such a hard worker. And again, just as team captain, but it's the backbone of the U.S. team.
So Raisman, of course, will leave the Olympics with two gold medals because the U.S. women's team won that competition. And she was fourth in the all-around.
Ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation for the runners-up as they leave the arena.
And bronze, of course, on the beam. So quite a haul for Ali Raisman. US picks up their third gold medal, and they'll finish second behind China in the artistic gymnastics medal table. China with four gold, three silver, and a bronze for eight medals. USA 3, 1, and 2, which will make six. Just add that up for myself here. I can still count to six, that's encouraging. And the Russian Federation, Japan, Romania, Hungary, Brazil, Republic of Korea, the Netherlands, all with gold medals. Nine nations actually collecting gold medals. So it's great to see it spread around to that extent. So just one more medal presentation to come. And it's this four exercise final. This is three of the strongest nations in the sport receiving more medals, USA, Romania and Russia. In that order, Raisman, Konor and Mostafina. Hope you can stay with us for the medals shortly.